Mr. Prashant, Mr. Asif, Abbasi Bhai, Francis, Nadeem, all the leaders. It means we still trust in Buxcoil. Do you trust in Buxcoil?
Yes.
Do you trust in Buxcoil?
Yes.
No, I'm not satisfied with this voice. Guys, if you have to go out in the market and make the loud voice of Buxcoil, so you have to shout with me, do we all love Buxcoil?
Yes. Yes.
Do we all love Buxcoil?
Yes.
Are we all going to stay together for Buxcoil?
Yes.
You sure?
Yes.
So now I am really very happy and excited about the Buxcoil. Why? Who wants to know? Nobody wants to know.
Everybody.
I am really happy and excited about Buxcoil. Do you all want to know why?
Yes.
Do you want to hear it from me?
Yes.
Or somebody else? You want to hear it from me or somebody else? Guys, we are already late 1 hour. So next time this will not be accepted. Okay, we all are in business. Do I have a trespass to talk? Do I have a trespass? You know trespass? All right. So I can say, next time we will not be getting late. We'll start it on time. All right?
Yes.
So first of all, let me introduce myself. Do you all know me?
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Some people doesn't know. I see a lot of new faces. My name is Shashi Raj Singh. I'm in Dubai from last 21 plus years. Hotelier by profession and networker by choice. So this is my choice. I choose network marketing. I choose Buxcoil. You choose Buxcoil. You choose Buxcoil. Why? To be a winner in life. All right? So now, let's set the ground rules first. Everybody, please put your phones on silent or switch off. Silent or switch off. Because if your phone will ring, you will not get disturbed. You will easily pick up your phone, go out and talk. The person sitting beside you will get disturbed. All right? So, are we on the same page?
Yes. Yes.
Switched off or silence?
Yes.
See, let me tell you something. Today's session is very, very important. As we are coming with the new live updates, from here, yours and your partner's life might get changed. As we all know, from last 3-4 months, some people were doing meetings, presentations, but 90% of us were not doing. Am I right or wrong? Right? So please, without taking your time, let me call upon a gentleman who is like now at the moment is my mentor. I trust him a lot. You all trust him. You might know him. He has the biggest team in the Buxcoil. You know the word called millionaire? Dreams is all above that now. He is all above that. So please, to listen to him, be concentrative. Don't look at your mobiles. Please help me to welcome Mr. Prashant Brahmbhatt.
Mr. Sasi. Good evening.
Good evening. Good evening.
Lots of you guys already know me. And if anybody don't know, my name is Prashant. Basically, by profession or study, I did Chartered Accountancy, finance degree from India. And I'm a networker by profession also, by choice also, and it is in my blood also. So I was born for this, I feel sometimes. So, first of all, I think voice is okay. Voice is coming or not? Okay. Volume button up. Now, it's okay. because mic is artificial and this is natural. So if the last people can hear me.
You stand in between, so everybody can hear.
No, no. Okay. Now it's okay? So basically, since last 2 months, people have lots of questions in their mind, yes? And those questions are even creating some confusion in our mind also, yes? Because lots of people are new also in cryptocurrency. How many people are only knowing cryptocurrency since last 6 months? Very new people in cryptocurrency. How many people are knowing cryptocurrency since only last 1 year? Okay. So normally you are 1 year old in cryptocurrency. Now, whoever is doing the cryptocurrency, the first cryptocurrency was Bitcoin. All of you know it?
Yes?
Yes.
Yes.
It has started in 2008-09 sort of. The world really knows about in 2012-13. Even we know Bitcoin. I think the voice is coming or not?
Yeah.
Yes.
I will come. So, in 2012, people really started knowing about Bitcoin, yes?
Yes.
And since then, we can, right now, if we want to learn cryptocurrency or we want to compare the cryptocurrencies, because right now there are more than, I would say, 1,000 mainstream-like cryptocurrencies, and more than 200 exchanges in the world, yes?
Yes.
On which you can trade cryptocurrencies. Most of you people already have training from me. So today I will not go deep in blockchain and technology because I think you all know and you all attended my training, yes?
Yes.
But today we will talk on the specifically that portion in which portion the people can take their decisions. Which cryptocurrency do we choose? Yes? And this is the main question confusing us right now, confusing our client right now. Yes? So today we will talk on main this issue. So after the Bitcoin, too many cryptocurrencies are there. Now only Bitcoin succeeded or after Bitcoin so many currencies have success also. Some other currency have also succeeded, yes or no?
Yes.
Even if you ask me, I would say first 50 cryptocurrency as per the market cap, they are successful currency or not?
Yes,
because sir. First 50, if you will take the 50th cryptocurrency, it has trading volume and it had gone even 5 times, 10 times, 20 times from the inception point. Yes?
Yes.
So if any currency had given even 5 times in 1 year, 2 year or 3 year, we will call that currency successful. So we have more than 50 successful cryptocurrency right now available. And let me show you some statistic. Everyone can see?
Yes.
So, why the world choose cryptocurrency over banking system? Anybody knows? Right here, right now, 97% or 98% of the international or national transaction or any type of transaction, retail or international or what, we are doing by banking system. Yes? And since last 50 years, we are using banking system, and banking system has developed our whole economy. So right now, we are depending upon banking. But do you all know why the cryptocurrency, why the world chose cryptocurrency over banking? Anybody? The main reason? Anybody knows the reason? Why we chose? Huh? What is the benefit of decentralization?
No more banking because the governance is not there.
I think
governance is also there. But see, what is our main point? What is our main concern that we are not using banking, or we don't want to use banking anymore, and we want to go towards the cryptocurrency?
We have the control
because it is
on our
secure
money.
And the transaction charges are very less.
Even I will tell you that transaction charge is there in Bitcoin or Ethereum or any coin, but some payment gateways are there, they have zero transaction charge.
The lead time also is reduced. The lead time with the cryptocurrency is reduced compared to the banking system.
Yeah.
Faster.
Open ledger.
The main point, because of we chose cryptocurrency over banking, is the future safety of our money. Now you tell, the bank is more safe or the cryptocurrency is safe? Because you know the technology, but whoever is not knowing the technology, let me tell you the basic reason why the world is going for cryptocurrency. The banking works on server. Yes? Every bank has a website, and every website wants a server. Yes? See, this is the basic point you should tell your client also, because they already don't know about these things. This knowledge is not common in the world. So first of all, you should tell them why we have to choose cryptocurrency for our future, and then they can think about, now if I want to go for crypto, then now I should go for which cryptocurrency. Then you can give them your project. Yes? But first of all, we need to convey that why we have to go for cryptocurrency and why not the regular banking system. So, this bank has website, runs on server. Now, if bank have 10,000 anyone will remit $100. If anyone will deposit $100 in the bank. So, bank should have how much cash retained with his branch or the central branch to give him his money back tomorrow. How much money bank should have? I'm asking in percentage.
2%.
If I have 2%, how can I give you 100%? Whenever you are going in bank, they are giving you 100% money back or not?
Yes.
If you are withdrawing 10,000 dirham or what amount, they are giving you or not?
Yes.
So if you deposited $100 and if they have to give you $100 back, then how much amount they should have in their bank? 100% or more than 100%?
More than 100%.
The normal thinking of the people are these only. Whoever attended my previous trainings, they only know the real truth of banking system. If I will tell you in starting that you will not know banking system, then you will all tell me that we are not illiterate people. We are professional people. We are very literate. We are working. So we know the banking system. But you know the banking system from front side. Yes?
Yes.
How they really operate from the back. The normal people, the common man is not having any knowledge of that. Let me tell you, if anyone puts any amount deposit in the bank, the international banking standards say that bank can only hold 3% amount of their deposit with them in cash. The rest 97% they should remit to the central regulator, or they should invest it in economy, or they should loan that amount to anybody, to any customer. So now if you put $100 in your bank, now the bank have only 3%, means $3 cash available for you, and rest 97 is either remitted to the central regulator, or it has invested, or it has given as a loan to any other customer. And these rate we will call CRR. Anybody knows about it? Cash reserve ratio. These digit is regulated by the central regulator in any country. Like for India, it is around 2.75%. And why it is there? Why the central regulator want to regulate this? Because in any country, if the total net worth of people is 1 lakh million or whatsoever is the amount, the total cash currency is only 2.5% or maximum 3%. How much? Total cash currency, means total printed cash currency in any country, you will not find more than 3%. So if any major bank will hold the cash, hold, what other banks will do? Can those banks can work or not? They cannot work. They cannot give even $10 to their customer because all the cash already holded by major bank. So that's why central regulator in any country is having the capping limit to retain the cash amount from your deposit. So bank cannot hold that amount. 97% amount is already invested in economy, but it is there on server. Yes or no?
Yes.
the data, your ledger is on the server, yes? So, I'm not telling that bank does not have the money. I'm not telling that. Bank have money even more than 100% what you gave them. If you gave them $100, they have money, I think, 150 to 200, it might be $250 also. Means twice the amount what you put. Because banks have their own assets also. But I'm telling about cash. They have only 3% of cash because whole economy have cash less than 3% or 3%. So is there any chance bank have cash more than that? And bank should not also have cash more than that. Now, everything is okay. Bank can perform all of their transaction. Is there any incident happen? You went to the bank and you want to withdraw your whole amount, let's say 25,000 or 50,000 dirham, and bank told you that we don't have money. Is there any incidents?
Yes. Many times.
Many cases.
No. Means common people. Yes. I'm not talking about 5 million or 10 million. I'm talking about 25,000 dirham, 50,000. Bank is giving every day. And most of the bank in the world do not deny. If they deny today, they will give tomorrow. So there is no big issue. But is there any incident they're not giving money since 15 days, 20 days, 30 days?
No. There are certain limits to withdraw the money.
Yeah, but you can withdraw your whole money if you want. In 7 days also, in 15 days also. But you can withdraw your, how it is happening, how it is possible, because 98% of our transaction, we are not doing those transactions in cash. Yes? If you have company in Dubai, if you are paying salary to anyone, if you are paying your house amount, your car amount, your any of the government fees, how you pay? By check? By wire transfer? So if you are transferring the money bank to bank, do you withdraw the cash and give, or you are just giving bank entries? So the transactions are wired only. So money goes from one bank server to another bank. All the money is digital. Yes or no?
Yes.
Now, up to this point, no problem at all. But on which server the bank is holding your data, this server, it is hackable,
yes,
or not?
Yes.
Hackable or not?
Yes.
You know, these days the technology is like cat and mice. Who will catch whom? I don't know. You also don't know. So, if one day your bank server got hacked and your bank announced that they don't have any record of your amounts, means they see, bank is working with the balance sheet. Here are the assets, here are the liabilities. So, you gave amount to the bank. So you are here, liability side, and bank have assets also, big assets, shareholding, these, that, assets are here. So I'm not telling that bank do not owe money from some people. Yes, they have assets, they can realize, but if they don't know how much you owe to the bank, can they pay you?
No.
If anybody have 5,000 dirham in bank, anybody have 50, anybody have 5 million, how they would know that who the guy is, 5,000 dirham or 5 million dirham? So momentarily, can they pay? Will they pay?
No.
Can you withdraw amount from branch? Okay. So if the server got hacked,
not withdraw from branch. But can you withdraw from ATM? Yes or no? ATM has money. You can you withdraw or not?
No.
You cannot withdraw from ATM also. If you cannot withdraw from ATM, can you withdraw from or can you transact with online transfer or wire transfer?
No.
So all the ways are blocked, and when they will solve this problem, then you can have your money back. Otherwise, bank will not pay a single penny to you. Can you do anything?
No.
So we are using cryptocurrency not for fast transaction, not for cheap transaction, but we are using cryptocurrency because there is a threat on every financial system in the world. Because that system is running on that technology which is hackable, which can be manipulated, and if that system will be manipulated, what will happen? Now you will tell me that banks have their backup with them, and it is not that everything is digital. They have their manual records also, so they can revive from that. Yes or no?
Yes.
But let me tell you, if anything happens like this, now the next thing is not repairable. What will happen? The 100% customer of bank, they suffered for 1 month, 1.5 month, and they did not have any access on their phone. Yes?
Yeah.
After 1.5 months, bank have cleared everything. They have revived all the data, and now the operation is perfectly good. But what will be the action of people? What they will do? They lost trust. What they lost? And trust is the center point of banking system. Now, if they lost trust, what they will do? They will go to the bank and they will ask for 100% of their money. Now, they will ask for cash, or they will ask for banker's check or FD document or something, blah, blah, blah. Some other than cash security. What they will ask?
Cash
only. Cash only? Because in our mind, if we all people close our eyes and have one word in our mind, money, what the picture will be front of our eyes? The paper currency. Is there any currency we love more than that? The FD document, the bonds from bank, the shares of the bank. We don't want. What we want?
Cash.
Yes? Either it is dollar, euro, pound, Indian rupee, or dirham. We want?
Cash.
So if the 100% people will ask
100%.
For the cash to the bank, can bank repay or not? Yes?
No.
Can any bank in the world repay?
No.
Okay. Bank cannot repay. So now the trust will not be zero. Now trust will be in minus. Yes? Now people will start allegations against bank, and whole banking system will be collapsed. Now government can help or not?
Yes.
Yeah. Government.
How?
No.
Because people want 100% cash, yes? What people want? 100% cash. And government even have only 3% of paper cash printed currency in the economy. So even government can repay 100% of debt?
No.
Not in the world. And if government will print even 1% more, the inflation will rise up to 15 to 20% in a year. So the economy will be hell in 3 to 4 years. inflation will rise enormously and the economy will matter. So these kind of threats, and this is only one threat, that hacker can hack the server. But what happens when people can hack the manager? Yes, the branch manager is also human. And you also, we also have seen in 2008 what happened. 2008, what happened?
Recession.
Recession? Let me tell you, my friend, in 2008, there was no recession at all in the world. That problem was totally different from recession. After that, the recession was took place. In 2008, what happened? The biggest financial institutions in US and all over the world, they have given loans. Means they have balance sheet. One side is asset, right? And one is liability. Yes? So they have took 100,000 or 100 million from people, or whatever is the amount. Let's say 100 million. They have invested 100 million in the economy. They have given the loan for house, big property, blah, blah, blah. Now what happened? They have given loan amount of 5 million for one house. And they accidentally realized that in today's economy, this house, if we will sell, it is on the asset side as a 5 million. But they didn't realize that if we will sell that house today, we will not also get $500,000. So 4.5 million is there on the balance sheet, legally. Nothing is illegal, but that is not liquidated. That should not be liquidate, so they don't have really that money. So they raise their hands that we cannot give you your money back. And people had now no trust in the financial institutions, and financial institutions are bankrupt. You heard sometimes the XYZ bank was bankrupt. Now, how the bank can be bankrupt? Yes? But this is the reality in the world, that our financial system really cannot give security of our money. Even they are writing that we are liable for that, but if they have asset, if they don't have anything, law gives them right not to pay us. That's why the Bitcoin is when Bitcoin was started in 2009, can anybody tell me?
Yeah. Aftermath of the recession.
The technology behind the Bitcoin, the cryptography, was already invented in 1990s and 1991. Some of the people, they have developed a cryptography system for the MasterCard and Visa, the online payment gateways, the credit card companies, they have transactions all over the world. So they want to timestamp their transaction and they want to keep their all transaction in one ledger. So for them, blockchain technology or the cryptography technology was already invented in 1991. So why it hasn't been used for making the currency in 1991? Because we didn't thought that we want any currency, because we are perfectly okay with the bank and financial institution. Yes?
Yes.
But when we felt that now our money is not safe anymore, because can we keep 5 5 million cash with us every time?
No.
So we have to put it anywhere in the economy. Either they are shares or securities or bonds or in any of the bank. Yes?
Yes.
We should keep that amount. And to whom we are giving that amount, there is no 100% guarantee that we will have that amount back. Yes? So that's why people started a different technological revolution, and by the product of that, we are having the first currency in cryptocurrency as a Bitcoin. So now everybody understood why we are choosing cryptocurrency? Why? Security. Whenever you will give your money to anybody, it is not 100% guarantee that you will in any case get that amount back. Yes?
Yes.
Everybody is earning from their hard work. Yes?
Yes?
Everybody wants that they earn more money, so after some certain age, they can use that money as a financial security. Yes? So that's why we want to keep our money safe, and that's why we want that nobody can snatch my money. That's why the blockchain and the cryptocurrency is there, because the big difference in blockchain technology is one person, one unknown person who named Satoshi Nakamoto, but there was no really real person in the history that they found, but he had developed a program, a software, works on the logics of mathematics and algorithm. Now what they did, bank and blockchain, both are running on computer, yes or not?
Yes.
Both are having server, yes or not?
Yes.
So how can we tell that bank is not safe and blockchain is safe? How many people understand this point? If I am newcomer in this system, and you are coming to me and you are talking about cryptocurrency, if I will ask you that please explain me how the bank is not safe and the blockchain is safe. Yeah, I also know that this is right. But if I will ask you how many people can answer? I want to know. See, we are pioneer guys in cryptocurrency. And no matter what you do, no matter you are doing job, you are doing business, doesn't matter at all. But right now, the cryptocurrency market cap is only $150 billion. How much? Worldwide banking transaction. Do anybody know this amount? Total turnover of worldwide banking transaction. Do you know the amount? Now I am asking only one question. After I will explain you how the blockchain is safe. If it is 100% safe, then you and your next generation will put money in bank or blockchain. Either it is Bitcoin, Ethereum, or any currency in the world, then I am not asking, but they will put money in blockchain or bank?
Blockchain.
Now, I even don't know this amount, but I know one small amount. All the banks in the world are charging minimum balance.
Yes.
Charge, yes?
Yes.
In Dubai, how much it is? If you are not maintaining minimum balance, let's say 1,000 dirham, I don't know how much it is.
25 to 30 dirhams.
25 to 30 dirhams, yes. This is the amount. So the minimum monthly minimum balance charge is 25-30 dirhams. And how much is total transaction by Dubai Economy in all the banks? It can be 10,000 times, it can be 1 lakh times. So, the minimum banking charge for minimum balance charged by all over the world's bank is $4.3 trillion USD. How much? $4,300 billion. 1,000 million is equal to 1 billion, and 1,000 billion is equal to 1 trillion. So cryptocurrency market cap is only 150 billion. How much? But the banking transaction minimum charge is 4.3 billion. It is approximately 25 to 30 times. So you can imagine, if all the world will be switched on the blockchain, how much will be the total turnover of cryptocurrency? Got it?
Yes.
So even that is not beginning of beginning. When we are sitting here, it is not beginning of beginning. We have lot more to see in our life in cryptocurrency. So if we will take this knowledge, can we earn or not? Whoever is the banker in 1980s, right now, they are living normal life or they are multimillionaire? Whoever was in the banking field in 1980s, right now what they are doing? They have their Rolls Royce, they have their villas, mansion. So that's why I'm telling you that you also have these kind of opportunities. You are seeing that in one day Bitcoin is giving 10%, 15%, 12% return. Which thing can give you 10% in? Which thing can give you 10% in a day? So, 4.3 trillion. Now, if these 150 billion will go to 4.3 trillion, every cryptocurrency averagely will go 20 times more. Yes?
Yes, sir.
And if we will only multiply our net worth 20 times, I think we can have financial security. Yes?
Yes.
Financial stability. So, why the blockchain is safe? One person made one program and he did program it slightly differently. After he programmed this system, he put first clause that after it get started, nobody in the world can change this program, even if it is himself. So after blockchain starts, nobody can reprogram the blockchain. And blockchain is not running on one computer. It is running on thousands of computers in the world. So I'm not going in further technology, but I will tell you this only, that blockchain have thousands of servers and the data is decentralized. Data is bifurcated among all. So if anybody wants to hack the data, they have to hack all of the computers simultaneously. Is it possible?
No.
And every 10 minutes, this system gets refreshed. this system is circulating new ledger. So hacker have to work within the time, and they have to hack 51% system, and they have to change the ledger. Then and then only they can.